Given several terms in a sequence, we want to determine if the sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. So for a quick review, if a sequence is arithmetic, then the pattern to find consecutive terms is to add a constant value each time, or more formally, consecutive terms have a common difference d, which is equal to a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which means if we select any term in the sequence a sub n and subtract the previous term a sub n minus 1, the difference d will always be the same. And for a geometric sequence, to find consecutive terms, the pattern is that we multiply by a constant, or more formally, consecutive terms have a common ratio, r, which is equal to a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1, meaning if we select any term in the sequence, a sub n, and divide by the previous term, a sub n minus 1, r will always be the same. Let's take a look at our two examples. Again, if we can analyze the sequence and determine the pattern is that we're adding a constant, or that the pattern is that we're multiplying by a constant, we can quickly and easily determine whether the sequence is arithmetic or geometric. Looking at this sequence closely, if we multiply negative 2 by 3, that would give us negative 6, but the next term is actually positive 6. So if we multiply by negative 3, that would give us the second term in the sequence. And again, notice if we multiply 6 by negative 3, we do get negative 18, and negative 18 times negative 3 is equal to positive 54. So it looks like we found the pattern. And since we're multiplying by the constant negative 3, this means our common ratio, r, is equal to negative 3, and we have a geometric sequence. Now, if we were not able to determine this pattern by analyzing the sequence, we'd have to rely on our formulas for d and r to determine if the sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. So for example, if we selected the first two terms and then found r, using the formula, we would have a sub 2 divided by a sub 1, 6 divided by negative 2 is equal to negative 3. This alone is not enough information to determine that the sequence is geometric, but from here we could start multiplying by negative 3 to see if the pattern works, or if we wanted to, we could select two other terms and see if we get the same value for r. For example, if we use the third and fourth terms, r would be equal to a sub 4 divided by a sub 3, 54 divided by negative 18 is equal to negative 3. So from here, we do have enough information to conclude this is a geometric sequence. If we did try to test to see if it was arithmetic, notice how if we use the first two terms, d would be equal to 6 minus negative 2, which is equal to positive 8. If we use the third and fourth terms, d would be equal to 54 minus negative 18, which is equal to 72. And we can quickly see the common difference is not the same. Therefore, this cannot be an arithmetic sequence. Looking at the second example, it can be more challenging when the terms are in fraction form. Let's go ahead and rewrite this so that 4 is a fraction. So we can write this as 4 over 1, comma 8 thirds, and so on. Now if we take a look at the numerator and denominator separately, we may see a pattern. Notice how 4 times 2 is equal to 8, 8 times 2 is equal to 16, 16 times 2 is equal to 32, and 1 times 3 is equal to 3, 3 times 3 is equal to 9. 9 times 3 is equal to 27. Which means the pattern is that we're multiplying the numerator by 2 and the denominator by 3 each time, which means we're multiplying by 2/3. And since we're multiplying by a constant, common ratio r is equal to 2/3. Which means we have a geometric sequence. But again, if we're not able to recognize this pattern, we have to go back to using our formulas for d and r to determine whether the sequence is arithmetic or geometric. Let's go ahead and use the first two terms to determine the value of r. So r would be equal to the second term, 8/3, divided by the first term, 4 over 1. But instead of dividing by 4 over 1, we're going to multiply by 1/4, the reciprocal. To simplify, there's 1, 4, and 4, and 2 4s and 8. Notice how r is equal to 2/3. Again, just from this, we cannot conclude this is geometric. So let's go ahead and use two other terms to see if we get the same value for r. Let's go ahead and use the second and third terms this time. So we'd have r is equal to the third term, 16/9, divided by the second term, or divided by 8/3, which is just the same as times 3/8. Again, this simplifies. There's 1/8 and 8, 2/8 and 16, 1/3 and 3, and 3/3 and 9. Notice how r is still 2/3. Therefore, this does confirm we have a geometric sequence. We could go ahead and try to find d using the first and second term and the second and third terms, but d will not be the same, which would verify this is not an arithmetic sequence. So when trying to determine whether a sequence is arithmetic or geometric, I think it is a good idea to look for a pattern first, because that can save us a lot of time. But if we can't find the pattern, we do have to use these formulas here for d and r to determine whether the sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.